Yo, 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 guys. There's not gonna be a lot of commentary on this video, but I wanted to record this trade as it happens. I'm still watching ICT's video, so yeah, I'm watching that, so I need to have the audio muted. I'll tell you what I'm seeing. Basically, we drew up in a new week opening gap. We came back down to bullish order block and bullish order block, and then we formed what appears to me to be a short-term high. Traded up into this bearish order block, which is also back here, this SIBI back here, and we have a large wick here, which here I'll put this one tick ahead of that so you see what I'm talking about. So we have the consequent encroachment of this inefficiency. This wick is, which is an inefficiently delivered price, and I'm looking to take two contracts off just ahead of the CE of that. And one contract if we come take out this short-term sell side, and then potentially we draw lower back to 61 halves, which would be the sell side liquidity down here. So just to give you an outline of the trade, we see bearish order block here. I actually was in before that, so not an optimal entry, but fine. New week opening gap is sitting higher. That drew price higher. We came like 1 point. We just came 1 point shy of it. So yeah, three ticks shy of the new week opening gap, and those relatively equal highs. We drew up into there, but didn't quite make it. So now I think that we should draw back down into sell side liquidity. I'm watching ICT's video, guys, so my camera's gonna go off, the audio's gonna go off, but we'll see. We're headed into New York open midnight in 1 hour and 20 minutes, so this trade could take a while. We will see. All right. I mean, I would be here to comment, but nothing has changed. So there's really nothing for me about which to comment, is there? Not really. That should be now a bearish order block, which should propel us lower. I also have a bearish order block trading into this green candle. I have a volume imbalance right there that price appears to be respecting for the moment. So all things considered, I feel pretty okay about this trade. That wick consequent encroachment should draw price. Sell side liquidity could also draw price. That order block that we just traded to could also draw price. So I think that my target here is pretty conservative. It's 9 3/4 points lower, and then 4 points from there, so 13 points. Overall, I think that the trade should work out. So that's about all I have for you right now. Not more to add. I believe that price is just waiting to do something. So just waiting for the right time to do something. We could be stopped out on this one. I don't feel great about it. Could still be drawing up to new week opening gap pretty easily. But I'll just let it get stopped out if that happens. I'm talking without my microphone. If you like watching the price action on a replay and see how I'm using ICT concepts without a whole lot of commentary from me, do let me know. I have to actually focus on trading, and most of that's going to be silent. There's really not a whole lot for me to say. There's a bearish order block, and I think it should come down to the wick inefficiency. I mean, that's pretty much it. So, you know, let me know if you just like watching it. Or if you really want like a whole lot of commentary. If you don't want a lot of commentary, then these longer videos are probably for you, right? You could feel all the, you know, nervousness or whatever in live price. All right, guys. Nothing more really to say. Hello. We're waiting. These candles here are not order blocks because there's no displacement, right? This is all efficiently trading. This is like time distortion, basically. That is a bear sorter block because you see there was displacement below. That was an algorithmic pivot point, basically, right? See a price displaced below that green candle. That makes that a bear sorter block. None of these candles have any displacement, so they're not order blocks. They're just time distortion, basically. The market is just waiting for the right time to do something. And all of Michael's macros are like from the 50-minute. They're like 20 minutes long, right? So anyways, he doesn't really teach this time of the day, so I'm not going to speculate too much other than to say the next key moment that we're coming up to is New York Open Midnight, which is resettlement for the day. And then it's the London session from 0200 to 0530. So we're looking at that. Anyways, none of these candles are going to be order blocks because there's no displacement. Order block needs to have displacement. Make sense? All right, I'm back. Hello. Hi. Not much more to commentate. We'll see if this trade plays out. I'm going to move the stop. Okay, I'll just lock in the profit. I'll lock in a full point. Just lock that in.
Find many, many.
Well, I want to have a little bit more exciting video where my buy limits get filled, but in any event, probably going to get stopped out on this. All right, guys, that puts us up 1625 on the day. Got $2,000 to go. And that was, I'll show you the executions. We were selling up here. It was a very small trade, right? But I was expecting it to draw lower. So we're going to work into the London session. And right now it's in a very dense range, so I just kind of want to wait for a minute, you know, see what it wants to do. We have bullish order, old bullish order blocks below, bearish order blocks above. I was wanting to see it draw to the 1 minute wick CE here, so you can see that was the wick on a 1 minute time frame, and I wanted to see it draw there. It got close, didn't quite get there. Now we're trading back up into this sell side imbalance, buy side inefficiency. So at this point, you know, it could trade up to new week opening gap, but I don't want to just instantly get back in the marketplace. So that was like a $200 trade, basically. Like $220. So, all right. Well, we got $2,000 to go, about $2,000 for the day. So that will be our profit limit for the day. That's all I got for you right now. Bye.